Please stand clear of the doors.
Hey guys, man, I'm usually so excited to be on the monorail, but it's so hot in here.
It's so hot.
Usually when you're on the monorail and it's cold, it's nice, but sometimes when it's this hot, it's like ridiculously hot.
I suck.
Hey, do you guys hear that?
What?
Is that Joey?
Yeah, for some reason I just jumped back in and it's just all of a sudden it's like, hey, you're in.
Oh, Grandpa.
Welcome to episode 54 of the Diz Hiz podcast. I'm one of your Iceman Joe.
I'm Alex.
I'm Adam.
Today we will be giving the Hiz on, for the first time in forever, a Frozen sing-along celebration. Were you shaking your head?
Oh, cuz you said ice and it's like, can we get a fan in here with an ice cube in front of it?
That's true.
Why
Alex,
why you gonna call me out?
Yeah, Alex forgot to turn the AC on, so it's kind of hot in here. But what do you guys think about this show?
I love it.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Yes.
Why do you guys? Okay. So I didn't call out names because you guys want me to start calling out names before I say anything.
Yep.
Okay. So Adam, why do you think it's amazing?
Because I went in thinking this is going to suck and it was going to be boring and the kids were too old for it. And it was really, really good. It goes back to the cast members. They make the show.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Not Anna and Elsa and what's his name? Sven.
Kristoff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, it's not them. It's, you know, the storytellers. They're the ones who make
the historians.
It.
Oh, no, that about it.
They're telling stories too.
And how about you, Alex? Why do you think that it's great? Would you say great, amazing? What did you say? Fantastic? Who knows what you said?
It's all the above.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, it's great. It's a good show. It is definitely entertaining. I think if I went into it before I actually liked the movie, because I didn't start liking the movie until like 3 years ago. I didn't watch it at all. So if I went into it without liking it, I bet you I would have dragged my feet going into it. But now that I like the movie, I was happy to go in there.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you told me how it was so funny, that made me want to go in even more. And then ever since then, I want to make sure I hit it every time I go to the park.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I enjoy it also. I think it's a great show. It's funny. The cast members do make the show.
Yeah.
Depending on who you get.
I haven't had a bad one, though.
No? There's some that are different. You're right. I haven't had any bad ones, but there's some that are better than others.
Mm-hmm.
For example, have you seen Ben, Equity Ben live?
Yeah, he wasn't as amazing as you make him sound.
No? How about you?
No, I have not.
Have you seen the African-American girl?
I have not.
She's awesome.
Is there only one?
I don't know. I just know I've seen her. I've seen her twice now.
Oh, really?
And she's really good.
So there's a cast member, his name is Equity Ben, and I've seen him probably about like 4 or 5 times, and if it's not him, I'm kind of disappointed that it's not him.
First name Equity, last name Ben?
Yeah, he's super funny, hilarious. He kind of goes off script. Maybe I know that he kind of had some issues with going off script a bunch of times.
I believe Joey said that on one of his recordings before.
Oh, really? And so maybe Alex saw him after he
think was
kind of like, hey, once you need to start going.
Tone it down.
Because what happens is the show starts coming about him and not so much about Disney and Frozen.
Right.
And that's what was going on. Because the times I went, he would pick out people in the crowd and just totally like get into them pretty
good.
Then
he needs to remind them, be like, I don't know if you know this, but the only reason the Jungle Cruise is what it is because an employee went rogue.
Yeah, that's true.
That's true. But I guess we'll get more into Equity Ben later on with some memories. How about
Alex? He's coming on, right? Joe had the reach out.
Yeah, he emailed him.
Joey, we need to talk to Joey about that. Because Joey does know him. And so he was going to reach out to Ben. And
so when Joey calls in,
maybe Ben will be on the show.
They'll be together.
Yeah, that'd be kind of cool.
If not, he's no longer got a segment. He's back with Duck Duck, whatever, Goof Duck.
Adam's like, I'm so angry today.
It's so
he's
hot
like,
in here.
He's like, it is. That's probably what it is.
Yeah,
it's so
it
hot
is,
in
yes.
here, and you're getting angry.
Yeah,
it kind of like the Hulk.
No, I was thinking the little fire guy from Inside Out.
Anger,
anger. Yes. Yes.
Whatever
that,
his
that,
name
that
is,
that little guy that's angry all the time.
So let's give it a rating. Let's give the show a rating. Okay, uh-huh. Alex,
yes.
What do you rate it?
I give it a 9.
9. Wow, that's pretty high for you, man.
It is.
Yeah,
really
that
high
is.
For me.
Yeah. God, right next to paying you to go in there.
If they paid me, I'd get a 10.
8.5. I wish there was a little more variation. I wish like maybe some things could change a little bit each time you went. You'd see something new.
Mm-hmm.
I did notice, you know, sometimes there's little jokes that get changed out. But overall, it's a really good show.
I give it an 8. You know, it's a nice place to go to get out of the heat.
Mm-hmm.
The show's cool. Funny. Yeah, it's cool in there. And it's like, what? How long's the show? You put that in the history?
Yes.
Okay, so how long is it?
30 minutes.
30 minutes. So it's like 30 minutes. I was like thinking 20, 30 minutes. So 30 minutes that you get to go kind of take a break out of the sun for a little bit because it's hot in Florida sometimes.
What?
Yeah. Conceal, don't feel, and let's get to the Hiz on the first time in forever, a Frozen sing-along celebration at Hollywood Studios.
Bees will buzz, kids will blow dandelion fuzz, and I'll be doing whatever snow does in summer.
For the first time in forever, a Frozen sing-along celebration debuted on July 5th, 2014 in Walt Disney World's Hollywood Studios. Frozen Sing-Along is a show that is hosted by two historians accompanied by Anna, Elsa, and Kristoff, who tell the story of Frozen. A large screen displays the lyrics so that the whole audience can partake in the singing of the hit songs. Frozen Sing-Along has been at almost all the Disney parks at one point or another, but is currently only still performing at Hollywood Studios and Shanghai Disneyland. Shanghai Disneyland opened their Frozen Sing-Along on May 7th, 2016.
Winter's a good time to stay in and cuddle, but put me in summer and I'll be a...
So, you know, we've kind of talked about the historians already.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And just like any other Disney attractions, the historians make the show, right? Yes. Just like in Jungle Cruise, what other ones do they have where the cast members make the show?
I mean, they're not that big of a part of the ride, but they do bring the experience is on Haunted Mansion and Tower of Terror.
Okay, yeah, they do, for sure. I mean, especially if you're going to Haunted Mansion and the cast members are not as kind of, you know, they don't have that dark humor.
Mm-hmm.
That the cast members, when they do have the dark humor, makes the experience definitely a lot better.
Even right? Several restaurants.
Oh, yeah.
That have, like, the Whispering Canyon.
Mm-hmm.
What's the other ones where they, you know.
Hope to do a review.
Hope to do a review, yes.
They don't really mess with you in that one, but they kind of... They do a mess. They mess
not,
with you.
Not the diner. The actors. There's when I went there last. I was just there last year, and I'm surprised they were still allowed to have the girl sit on some random guy's lap in the audience and flirt with him. I'm like, okay. Thought it was pushing a little for Disney.
Yeah, and prime time. You know, we talked about that before. Mm-hmm.
The new Star Wars ride.
Oh yeah, the new Star Wars ride for sure. The cast members are...
Mm-hmm. I wouldn't know. I haven't been on it.
Yeah, me either. Yeah. It's ridiculous.
I know. Those people who've been on it twice, they're on a podcast and they didn't record it for Bride the Hiz.
I'll record it next time I go on it, guys. 6 months later.
Yeah, hopefully we'll be able to go back soon. You know, hopefully things will start getting a little bit better.
So if you just heard a sound, that would be a Patreon member joining in on the Discord.
Yep, Tara just jumped in our Discord live chat and live listen. She is listening now.
Oh, Joey's back. And how can they join in on that, Joe?
How can they join in on our listening to our shows live? Yeah, they can go ahead and just go to Patreon, Diz Hiz 65, and you can join our Patreon. We have different tier levels. The first tier level is just for... Who's that? Joey, are you there?
Yeah, for some reason, I just jumped back in, and it's just... all of a sudden, it's like, hey, you're in.
Oh, Grandpa.
Yeah, I'm just that senile old man. Hang on, I'll figure it out.
Okay, no problem.
Hang on. How do you close window?
This is going to give us a good cutting room floor.
Did it work?
No.
No, you're still
there. Oh, I got you, Joey. I got you. Do you just want to get muted? Do you want to listen, Joey, or just want to get, do you want to be out of here?
I got to send somebody, a buddy of mine's buying a house. I got to send him some links. So I jump back in.
I'll make sure you send him the link to dizhiz.com.
Make sure to send the link to dizhiz.com. Here you go, Joe. I'll help you, I think.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah. So if you want to join in on all the Discord chat and mm-hmm. listening
yeah, so
to
if
shows.
If you want to go ahead and, you know, listen to us live, just go ahead and go to Patreon / I think it is dizhiz65. And you can join our Patreon. There's different tier levels. The first tier level, if you join, is just to help us support us. But the other three does come with the Discord, where you're able to listen to our shows live and have lots of fun with our other members.
Yep, a lot of talking, a lot of messaging back and forth throughout the day about Disney stuff. And sometimes non-Disney stuff. It's pretty fun, though.
Oh, we also, just real quick on there, during episodes, I do, and I know quite a few other Patreon members, post pictures that are based off of the episode that we're
doing. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, last week we did Art of Animation, and our members were posting pictures of them at Art of Animation, which was a lot of fun to see.
Yeah, and we have some of the Hidden Mickeys posted up there as well.
Yep, and they're talking, of course, you know, we got our members who are giving us, like, ideas to what to kind of promote. We also do giveaways, and this next week, we are going to be giving away a $10 gift card to Shop Disney, so you can go ahead and get some cool Disney stuff. That might be able to get you, like, a mug. And then next month, we have, like, a really big giveaway, which Ooh. Adam did a...
It's not really big, it's 8 by 11.
Yeah, it's 8 by 11, but it's a really, I mean, it's a really awesome job that you did painting Figment, and we're going to be giving that away next month.
The printer printed it on there.
No, you did not. You painted it. You did paint it and you drew it too.
Yeah, if you want to see it, head over to Instagram, Diz Hiz A, and you'll be able to see the Figment painting.
Frozen Sing-Along was initially part of a Frozen-themed event, Frozen Summer Fun, which took place in Hollywood Studios from July 5th to September 1st in 2014. At this summer fun event, you could hear Olaf chiming in over the speakers to let everyone know how his day is going. Wandering Oaken's trading post in Frozen Funland was open inside of Soundstage 1. Here, Oaken and his cousin created a funland with cold weather, activities, and unique photo opportunities. Guests could enjoy cooling down inside Premier Theater with the For the First Time in Forever, a Frozen sing-along celebration, where Anna and Elsa join the royal historians of Arendelle for a fun and comedic retelling of unique history of their kingdom, filled with delightful sing-along moments from Frozen. At 11 a.m., Elsa and Anna lead an Arendelle parade down Hollywood Boulevard in a horse-drawn sleigh. At 5:30 p.m., each day was a dance party with a DJ and live band by the Sorcerer's Hat Icon Stage, and everything wrapped up with a 9:45 p.m. grand finale fireworks display themed to the Frozen songs. After the event ended, Frozen Sing-Along was such a success that on June 17, 2015, the show was put in Hyperion Theater across the Echo Lake. The Hyperion Theater was opened as Superstar Theater when the park opened as MGM Studios, which housed the attraction Superstar Television. Superstar Television ran from 1989 to 1998. Doug Live, which ran from 1999 to 2001, and American Idol Experience, which ran from 2009 to 2014. For the first time in forever, a Frozen sing-along celebration reopened on June 17, 2015, along with the renaming of the building to Hyperion Theater.
Wow, Alex, you are doing so much better at reading. That was, like, perfect, no mistakes.
Yeah, you, like, didn't make any mistakes, and there's, yeah, it's pretty good, Alex.
I'm out of breath.
Why you out of breath?
Because it's hot in here.
It is really hot in here. I'm not going to lie to you, that water that you have sitting on your little booth right there
looks good.
No joke.
Yeah, all that water's going behind
me. I brought a big thing of water.
I think you should go in and go get water for me, because you forgot.
I don't own water.
So it's kind of interesting how the show has moved around so much.
Oh, yeah. And it's interesting, it started as an event. And then it's so successful that they made it an actual thing that lasted longer.
Yeah, I think that, cool. I mean, I don't understand how, why wouldn't they do that with the Muppet Show, the Great Moments in American History? I mean, I feel like that was a pretty popular show at Magic Kingdom. I feel like...
Because it wasn't as much of a...
Success.
As the other one.
But I feel like there was a bunch of people there, right?
The Muppets? No.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like but a lot of people didn't even know that was going on. I didn't even see this Frozen sing-along show before it was in this theater. Like, I had no idea. Like, any of this stuff right here, had no idea about it.
Yeah, I know I wasn't there in 2014, but do you remember at all the summer of 2014 when they had the summer fun event?
I was there, and I don't remember it.
No. 14, I believe I was Universal then.
But I would have to say, though, I think it's not that the show was so much popular as the... Frozen was huge.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
People knew about Frozen, you know, and they were probably, people were maybe even just going for this show. They were going to Hollywood Studios just for the show because Frozen was so big, you know, and kids loved it.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I'm sure the show was good at that time because I didn't see the show back in 2014. But, you know, Frozen was just a huge franchise. That's the reason why it did so well. But now it's usually a full house. I don't think I ever went in there, and it wasn't like when you go to the Muppets 3D. Mm-hmm.
It's not a full
attraction.
At all. No.
It's rarely ever full. Like, this is almost always full still. Yeah. And I mean, I feel like it still would have been.
Because it brings in the kids, though. That's why. Muppets, there's nothing out there right now for Muppets to bring in the kids until they bring back
Muppet
the show.
Babies.
Is that a big thing right now?
I mean, I know Joe's son loves Muppet Babies. My daughter loves Muppet Babies.
Maybe once they get this new show out, it'll have a resurgence.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And maybe they can do some updating to the show. But I feel like, I mean...
Yeah, to the little Waldo character. They need to update him big time.
What Waldo?
Did we just talk about this?
Yeah,
what
we
Waldo character?
Oh, yeah. Niels, they need to update Waldo. The blue seal-looking thing
that carries
the
show.
Yeah. I feel bad.
White Waldo is like the main thing of that show.
I know what you're talking about. I feel like, though, Frozen 2 went straight to Disney Plus, right? And
what?
I feel
what
didn't it go to, not straight to? I'm sorry, not straight to Disney Plus. But Frozen 2 was released early because of COVID. What wasn't it?
It was released in Disney Plus early. Yes.
Right. Yeah, it was released Disney Plus early,
uh-huh.
And I feel like the show missed out on like a resurgence of people wanting to see the show because the park shutting down and stuff. I think that more people would be like, "Oh, Frozen 2's out."
No, because they would have went when it was in the theaters.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
I'm curious to see if they end up. Changing it for Frozen 2 at all.
I guess we're going to find out here in a couple months.
Yeah they should. There's no we already said, just like the Mickey thing, it's a video. There's no reason you can't change it up real quickly. You know, have different, you know, events, like during different times of the year, do different songs. Mm-hmm. Have it like every other couple months, switch off what movie you're doing.
Yeah,
that'd be awesome.
Frozen 2. Yeah, I know. These ideas.
Frozen 2, they should put a Frozen 2 section in that. Right, like Adam's saying,
maybe do like every other show switches.
They have to remember
what? Who has to remember
the storytellers? They have to like change it up.
They have a different. I mean, do storytellers do back to back shows?
It's the same storytellers the whole time.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's right. They
just like
the
Lion King.
Lion King. Yeah.
For the first time in forever, a Frozen sing-along celebration is pure entertainment for family members of all ages. The Royal Historians of Arendelle tell the enchanted story of Frozen, making sure to stop to sing the hit songs as a big screen on stage show clips from the movie with the lyrics. There will likely be a little bit of chair dancing as a whole crowd erupts into an energetic song. Anna, Elsa, and Kristoff join the historians on stage during parts of the show. The conclusion of For the First Time in Forever includes an encore of Let It Go, complete with Snowfall. People go there for the Frozen sing-along, but return for the Royal Historians. They steal the show with their funny jokes and mannerisms. The historians poke fun at the story, themselves, and even the audience, and are sure to keep those non-Frozen fans entertained. There are about 10 shows per day, and the shows run about 30 minutes each. During the winter season, there is an extra encore song when Olaf comes out. He leads the whole cast in that time of year song. After the show, year-round, you can head left from the exit area and go get a photo taken with Olaf.
So Disney sing-alongs have always been popular. I remember growing up and just watching Disney sing-alongs like on VHS. Do you guys remember that or no?
No.
You don't? You didn't have a childhood. Go ahead, Adam.
I vaguely remember that. I used to have a book that my parents got from Magic Kingdom, and it was a keyboard, and it had the colors on the keys. And then you played along, and it had, you know, the words there, so you'd be singing and playing your own music.
Yeah.
The one I remember most is Zippity Doo Dah. I used to play.
Okay. Yeah, I do. I think I remember things like that also. Oh, yeah. Do you remember? Oh, you're like bringing me back to like a whole different thing, like when I was a kid.
Oh, I'm getting you in the feels, aren't I?
Yeah. Like they used to have like a little keyboard, right? You talking about?
Isn't that what I just
said? Yeah, that's what you said. Yeah.
You'd play a note, and then like you could read and then play the music same time, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So that was pretty cool how they had that. They don't have that anymore.
Yeah, and that was, I mean, your own sing-along, because, mm-hmm, you know, had the words right there for you.
Yeah.
I'm sure my parents appreciated me singing that in the back of the car on the way home.
Yeah. So, you know, the music that goes with Disney is pretty iconic, I would say. I mean, I feel like Disney, the cartoons, the music that goes along with the cartoons, the music is just as important as, like, the story itself.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
For sure.
And, I mean, it kind of, so, I mean, I feel like they should have different types of these attractions where it's like people can go and kind of interact with the cast members, interact with the Disney movies, and there should be more Frozen type sing-alongs.
You two haven't been, but I told you this is what Beauty and the Beast should have been.
Right. Yes, exactly.
Yeah, but it's not though.
Yeah.
Because when
that's what we thought it was going to be.
Right.
Yeah, because that would have been awesome.
We heard Beauty and the Beast sing-along. We're like, it's going to be just like Frozen.
I mean, it's not like they don't already have costumes.
Yep. And it'd be cool.
Alex is like staring at me. He's like, what do you mean they don't have costumes? They had the Beauty and the Beast,
the show,
the live
Hollywood
show.
Studios.
Hollywood Studios.
Have you been
there?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So okay. I'm saying they already have like templates. You know, if they need to make more, they know how to make more.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, but there's a whole bunch of, I mean, they can do a Little Mermaid. They can go ahead and, I mean, obviously have Beauty and the Beast. There's a whole bunch of other things they can do.
They kind of already have a Little Mermaid in the sit down show, right?
Yeah, but I mean, it's not like a sing along. Like, they don't have the words up on the screen.
No, they could change it to that.
Yeah.
There's another one, Niels.
You know, someone, I think Steve was sending me something in our chat a couple weeks ago, maybe like last week, where it was like a YouTube sing-along, and they were trying to see how long they can go without singing along with the words, you know?
Oh, yes, I saw the post.
I mean, it's a thing. This sing-along is a thing. Obviously, they did the sing-along with during the whole virus. You know, they had the sing-alongs, mm-hmm. two of them that they did,
yeah.
right?
ABC, right?
They should do that more in the parks, I think, where they kind of get families interacting with the songs.
Mm-hmm. Well, just those two, Beauty and the Beast and Little Mermaid, just right there. They already have the setup for it.
Yeah.
They
could yeah, you're right.
It can be fixed easily. I love the interaction with the historians in the show. My favorite part of the interaction with the historians is when they're about to do the puddle part, which you told me about, doing mm-hmm. the same puddle.
Yeah, yelling it out loud.
Yelling out loud. And I think that thing, and then a couple other things they do in the show with historians where you can interact with them a little bit, or interact, be part of the show in a way
mm-hmm.
that really makes a show
if they
really
pinpoint
fun.
You out,
yeah,
kind of like in Monsters Inc. Laugh Factory.
Oh
yeah,
yep. Yeah, it's cool when they definitely get the people involved in the show.
Yeah.
In 2015, Disneyland decided to get in on the Frozen fun, so they too hosted a Frozen fun event from January 7th to May 15th, 2015. This event temporarily took over Muppets Vision 3D, Stage 17, Downtown Disney, and an Animation Academy. Muppet Vision 3D Theater was renamed Crown Jewel Theater and is the venue that held the Frozen sing-along show. In Stage 17, next door to the Crown Jewel Theater, you will find a snow adventure. Everything covered in snow and made a winter wonderland with places to sled, slide, and even build a snowman. There was even a place to meet and get pictures with Olaf on your way out. You could take a ride on the new Storybook Land canal boats and see the new town of Arendelle that has been added. There's also Olaf's Frozen Ice Rink in Downtown Disney that was open until the end of February. Although the event officially ended on May 15, 2015, the venue held the Frozen sing-along show until April 17, 2016. It was then closed and the theater was renamed the Sunset Showcase Theater, which started showing movie previews that changed throughout the years, from 2016 to 2019. Starting in April 2019, the Sunset Showcase Theater began showing Mickey's PhilharMagic. Eventually, at Hollywood Land and Disney California Adventure, Frozen Live at the Hyperion premiered in May of 2016. A version of the show is shown on Disney Cruise Line ship Disney Wonder under the name Frozen, a Musical Spectacular.
I think they need to have that more often when a movie is coming out. They have an event, you know, like that. You know, the movie is coming out, so they, you know, put the snow where you can build a snowman, things uh-huh. like that. They have perfect opportunities many of the times, but then you don't really see much. Lion King came out, you know,
like the live action one, you mean?
Live action.
Like Lion King?
Yeah, when the live action Lion King came out, you know, there wasn't a big thing. You know, they could have redid the Lion King show.
Yeah, that would have been cool. That's a really good idea, too, because
added something different.
I thought they did add some things, like some photo ops, I think, over at Animal Kingdom. Didn't they add those statues of, like, Puma
yes,
and all them?
Yes, going across
the
log, yes.
Yeah, but it's not really as much. I know what you're saying. They should definitely add more to go ahead and kind of promote what they're doing when they have all these people going to the parks, and there's no better way to promote, I think.
I mean, I was walking around. I didn't hear Beyonce or Childish Gambino singing. Like,
yeah.
I think they have opportunities, you know, to change small little details up just for events, but that they don't take.
Mm-hmm. But do they need, I mean, maybe they feel like it's not worth the time, I guess. Maybe they want to go ahead and put their time into other things. Maybe it's not worth the time because I know they're going to go ahead and get the, I mean, everyone knows when something new Disney's coming out, right?
Yeah, but all right. So like when Toy Story 4 came out,
mm-hmm.
they put a Forky statue out in Toy Story Land.
Yeah.
Did they?
Yeah, they did.
Oh.
Well, you know, like, we can get a photo.
You're saying that's not enough? Or
no, it's not. Mm-hmm. No, I don't think so.
Yeah.
But Toy Story 4 did so well, though.
Sorry, they did add a armband to Bo Peep.
Yeah,
but
they did.
That movie did so well. Why do they not want to go ahead and put more money into advertising that stuff, you think?
I mean, why not? It brings in people. It would give another reason to come back, right? Isn't that Walt's thing?
Yeah, for sure. I can see, because they want to see the new Bo Peep or the new... but usually they have the new characters.
No, that's why I said they added... but it was just, stays there all the time. And then for Bo Peep, they just added the armband on her. I just think they could, like when the soldiers come out, they could have a different show.
Mm-hmm.
Just... You know, small things, but you know, it is a time thing. But you know, it's not like Disney doesn't have the money.
Yeah, well, now
to pay for the, you know, well, yeah, now,
yeah, now they have to.
But this all happened way before then.
Yeah, you're right.
Have you been on the Disney Wonder?
Yes, I have been on the Disney.
So, did you see this show?
Yeah, I saw the Frozen show.
It was good?
Really good. Yeah, didn't you see my notes?
Do you not listen to the episodes? We did the History on the Wonder, and he told us how good the show was.
That's what I thought. I just wasn't remembering.
So, yeah, I was about to say I got to watch the Frozen on the show on the Wonder. Great show. All different music. I mean, every boat has a different musical.
Yeah,
and all the musicals that are on the boat are really, really good. I mean, the sets are great. The ships.
Make sure you pronounce that one good.
Yeah, I know. They're all great. The performers are top notch. The sets are amazing. And it's really enjoyable to watch. You know.
So I guess the California show is more like that than like our Frozen sing-along.
So it's like goes over the whole story.
Yeah, and it's more like a play, I guess, right?
Yep. Yep, yeah. It's like a play, like a musical, you know. So like ours kind of, it's not like that. Ours is this has like the songs, like the more popular songs, and the historians are kind of telling the story as this is like the actual characters is like Anna and Elsa up there, and they're redoing the whole movie.
Yeah.
Yep.
Disneyland Park in Paris held their own summer event from June 1st to September 13th, 2015, at the Chaparral Theater in Frontierland under the name Frozen Songs. It is a similar show to Frozen Sing-Along and was the first version that featured Olaf. Shows ran several times daily with separate French and English language presentations. It first ran from June 1st to September 13th, 2015 as a summer event, but was scheduled to return on November 14th as part of the Christmas event. However, due to a terrorist attack in Paris on November 13th, 2015, both Disneyland Paris and Walt Disney Studios Park were closed from November 14th until November 18th. As of November 17th, 2019, Animation Celebration in Disneyland Paris reopened as Frozen, a Musical Invitational. This attraction features two key musical scenes featuring Frozen characters and an opportunity to meet Olaf before leaving the attraction. Hong Kong Disneyland had a Frozen event as well. Their almost identical show, named simply Frozen, was located in the pavilion between Adventureland and Grizzly Gulch. It was the former home of the Revenge of the Headless Horseman. It ran from June 11, 2015 until October 4th, even though the event officially ended on August 30th. At Shanghai Disneyland, Frozen Sing-Along is located in Fantasyland at the stage in the Evergreen Playhouse. This was the first Frozen Sing-Along show that was not opened for a seasonal event. It debuted on May 7, 2016. In November 2019, it started featuring songs from the sequel, Frozen 2. The magical land of Arendelle is coming to Disneyland Paris, which is projected to open in 2023. Two other locations are also getting their own Frozen lands. Hong Kong Disneyland is opening theirs in 2021, and Tokyo Disney Sea in 2022. The first rendering of the land reveals a Scandinavian-style village centered around a vast 7.4-acre lake based on the fjord in the films. It will host water-based shows with seats offering audiences a 360-degree view of day and night performances, complete with fountains, music, lights, and special effects. At the base of a more than 130-foot snow-capped mountain, there will be a recreation of the Port of Arendelle. A replica of Elsa's Ice Palace will be located at the mountaintop. Wandering Oaken's Sliding Sleighs will be a coaster that takes rides through the Kingdom of Arendelle, only at Hong Kong Disneyland. The second attraction will be based on Frozen Ever After, the popular attraction at Walt Disney World, and will open across all three parks.
Some of those rides seem kind of cool, right?
Yeah.
I mean, that one roller coaster one seems really, almost like, kind of reminds me of like the Matterhorn or Space Mountain. But I think that's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's crazy that a version, not the Frozen sing-along exactly, but a version of the sing-along has been at every park, just not always not there forever.
And then some even incorporated Frozen 2.
Yeah, one did.
Yeah.
And I like how the events go on and then the events stop, but the sing-along part continues for another month because they're like, people like it so much, we have to keep it going.
Uh-huh.
Even though the event officially ended, they always keep it going just a little longer for that one special show.
Yeah, and it's kind of like they do that with a lot of things at Disney. I feel like at Christmas time, you know, they have the holidays and all that, and that usually goes, I mean, Christmas is December 25th, and usually well into January, you can still see all the holiday decorations or all around the park. So they usually wait till after the marathon. That's mm-hmm. like in January, and they take it all down. So they usually let things go for a little bit longer than what they say.
So now the fact that they are building building attractions for this, there is no way there is not a Frozen 3.
You really think so? Works.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. I think they're going to get married. You have to see them get married, right?
I guess.
Kristoff and Anna.
Unless something else happens.
Well, something else obviously is not going to is going to happen.
You sure?
Probably.
They'll have some kind of crazy event happen? Something, some way for the characters to get over something?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and grow.
Wow, that'd be weird.
And have character development? Yeah, of course.
There's going to be like a peak in the story and then a plateau and then...
we should write the script.
Yeah.
They probably already have it done.
I wish we were getting a Frozen Land.
In this
Me
room.
Too. Yeah, I know, man. It's so hot.
It's
in
so
here.
Hot.
I'm so
Somehow
thirsty.
It's getting hotter.
I know. I'm so
you know
thirsty.
What's so sad is like this was all the complaints the first couple of episodes in this room.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A year later.
Alex, have you not learned when summer is in Florida?
I feel like if you, like, next time,
Bees let's, go
let's
buzz.
Say, let's say the next time you forget to turn the AC on in here, you probably just go bring out waters to us.
Because when it's summer, I'll be up. I forget what he says. Not a puddle.
You should just go.
A happy snowman.
Yeah, happy snowman.
We here at Diz Hiz enjoy the Frozen sing-along and think it is a must-see, even if you're not a Frozen fan.
There's no hidden Mickeys. According to Steven, what's his name? What's the guy with the yellow book? Yellow Mickey book.
Oh, the guy who does the hidden Mickeys or whatever? Like the books that are sold inside the parks? I'm not sure.
According to the 8th edition book, there are no hidden Mickeys there.
How about the 7th edition?
I have it. I'll go check. I'm going to go ahead and I'll go ahead and take that bet that it's still not going to be in there. Now, the 9th edition, when they come out because of the new rides, then maybe they went and put something. But nope, no hidden Mickey, so we are on to memories.
Memories, memories, talking about those Diz Hiz memories.
Okay, Adam, you have any memories?
Yes, I do. And it actually wasn't that long ago when I found out that you're supposed to shout the word puddle. And I told Melissa, I'm like, you got to shout it out. And when you shout it out, they're going to like criticize you and they're going to scold you. They're going to point at you. The historians will.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And so she normally doesn't do things like that. And then sure enough, she got the courage to yell out puddle. Guess what? So did half the theater.
That's what always happens.
No, it does not. Go watch some YouTube videos. There's like, you can find YouTube videos where there's like two or three people doing it.
Uh-huh.
No, this was literally the half of the theater.
Oh, gosh.
She's like, they didn't even hear me. Like,
that's
that was a waste.
That's funny because my memory is after you told me about the whole puddle situation, I was like, next time I go to that, to it, I'm going to yell puddle.
Mm-hmm.
So the whole show leading up to it, Christine's like, you can yell puddle? You can yell puddle? I was like, yeah, I'm going to yell puddle. I'm going to yell pretty good. And Emma had fallen asleep on me.
Oh,
so
no.
I couldn't be loud. So when it came up, I was like, I'm still going to be loud. I'm still going to say puddle. You know, I'm a loud guy.
It's worth it to
so
wake your daughter up.
I'm going to say puddle loud, but not going to be super loud. I say it, right? But a guy two rows behind me says it three times louder than me, and he gets called out by the historians because of it. And I'm like, well, I said it too.
Right. So it was just basically the two of you yelling.
It was
loud,
like three
right?
or four of us. Right. Yeah. So but he was super loud.
Right.
And so like I was just like, it's like, I didn't even do it.
Yeah. We just got in at the word where everyone in that room knew.
So you didn't say it loud because of Emma?
I didn't say it as loud as I could have. Yeah.
Because you're pretty loud.
Right. I am loud. But that guy said it, but I don't think it ever would have been as loud as
right.
him because that was crazy loud.
If
he
didn't know he was going to need to be that loud, he wouldn't have to be. Like, are you going to really, if you think you're the only one that's going to stand up and shout, are you going to shout at the top of your lungs?
Alex
like,
would.
Just like screaming. At
Alex would.
Yeah, I kind of would. But I also was really intimidated about making sure I got my timing right.
Yeah, that could be bad.
Right.
I was just like looking at you like, what are you talking about?
Sit down, you ruined the show.
They kick you out. So memories I have of going is just going and seeing Ben. I just thought he was hilarious. There's one time he went, and it was every single time I seem to go to the Frozen sing-along, it's like raining outside.
Really?
Yeah. So it was raining, but it stopped raining, you know? And there was this one guy, and he had his poncho on inside. And Ben was on him about wearing ponchos like the whole show. He was on this guy about wearing a poncho. He'd be like, "You'll kind of be like that guy. He's wearing a poncho inside." And he was just on him, and it was pretty funny. If I was the guy, I probably would have left. Not the show.
I mean, he has a poncho on.
I'm pretty sure after like the second time, and if Ben would have saw that he was kind of upset, he probably would have stopped. But I think the guy was kind of like going along with the whole bit.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, we talked about it earlier, but I do like how they keep it so cold in there, which is nice.
Yeah, because it's frozen.
Yeah. And then the snow at the end's cool. The it's bubbles. Bubbles, right?
Yeah.
But it's fun.
Like foam kind of. Yeah.
We usually sit in like the front left area.
Not bubbles like, you know, you get the wand, not that type of
no,
bubbles.
No, it's like a special
foam
machine.
Yeah, it's like a foam thing.
Hey, Joey, what you drinking?
Gentlemen, hello and good evening from beautiful Disney Springs. How you doing tonight?
Good, Joey. How you doing?
I'm good. So Disney is still kind of sort of closed-ish, but Disney Springs is open and kicking some tail. So I swung by Amorette's to grab the Arendelle Aqua Prosecco drink. Mm. I'm feeling bougie. It made sense. I grabbed some fancy chocolates and cheese I can't pronounce and said, I'm going to crush one of these. Which then turned into three of these, which then turned into me asking the girl behind the counter to tell me where I live so I can Uber home. But it was worth it.
And what's in it?
It's basically a Prosecco drink. So it's a very fancy, what am I looking for? Not the thing you drink at brunch, not a Bloody Mary, a
mimosa.
Champagne and orange juice. So it's pretty cool. You get it at the chocolate place. Millennium Pink. I'm not familiar with that color, but it is what it is. Not bad. It's basically champagne and orange juice with a few little things to make it sparkle. So, well, here we go. This was the thing I'm missing. Prosecco. Bulls. Why is everything so hard to pronounce if it's from France? God. Mountain Graton. Look, there's alcohol in it. What do you want?
Yeah.
There's alcohol. It's got champagne. It's got something to make it blue. It's got something to make it orange flavored. And it's got a white chocolate garnish. Mm. It's delicious. And they went down way too easy. So the good news is T-Rex was open. So I was able to go grab the world's fattest burger after. So I'm feeling pretty good. So the Frozen Ever After? We're talking about the show that's over at Hollywood Studios and not the ride, correct?
Yes.
All right. I get this mixed up all the time. The show's brilliant, not going to lie. It was, I had to jump on the Skyliner, take the Skyliner over to Riviera, grab an Uber at Riviera to scoot me over to Disney Springs, grab three of these and meet you guys back at the show. But it was worth it. The drink was good.
We did something like that last week.
Not bad for $19, right? Money well spent.
Yeah, last week we took the Skyliner over to Art of Animation.
I love the Skyliner. I don't care what people say. That is my new favorite way to just to go back and forth. It's a blast.
Yeah.
You hang out, you get your air conditioned ride. I don't know if you talked about it or not. Always ask for a Skyliner that doesn't have a graphic on the side because it doesn't obstruct your view.
Okay. That's kind of a good little.
I can't wait to try
it. You can always hold for one because every fourth one or every third one has a graphic from a different Disney movie or a cartoon or something Disney related. You're always better off just holding for one that doesn't have a graphic, especially if you're going to videotape it or do anything like that. So it's always worth it.
Hey, Joey, you know Amaretto's, right? That's where you got the drink at?
Yeah, the chocolate place.
And is that by Ghirardelli's?
Kind of. It is right next door to... all right, so you got the World of Disney.
Yep.
And if you go all the way to the far right, directly across from the World of Disney is that place that has all the poutine.
Oh, yeah, I know you're talking about.
Directly across from the poutine place. And for some weird reason, okay. I want to know, like, so I get that every city in America has, like, a city planner. They're the dude that's like, yo, we got to put the four-way stop here. Uh-huh. We got to put the McDonald's next to the mall, that type of thing. For some weird reason, the bougiest chocolate joint I've ever been to in my life is, like, next door to a Harley-Davidson dealership. I just don't know where they were going with that. I don't get it. And then that's across from the Under Armour,
Yep.
It's like there's no symmetry there, and I don't know what they were going for. I'm not mad. It's cool. I'm gonna go get my Harley Davidson hat and my chocolate and my Mickey ears and a shirt that's really, really tight. Like, that's cool if that's what you're down for. But I just want to know what their logic is in putting those places next to each other.
Have you gotten chocolate there?
What's up?
Have you gotten chocolate from there?
Oh, I love that place, dude. The first time I had chocolate there, I was with one of my regular clients. She's a travel agent from Texas, and she was in town with one of her lead persons, and we're at the Riviera staying on their concierge level, and we're just sitting down hanging out. The dude was mad nice, and he was like, have you been to the Amorettes or over at Disney Springs? And we're like, no, is it good? He goes, one moment. He actually sent one of their concierge over to Disney Springs to pick us up chocolate to bring it back over.
That's a long moment.
Yeah, baller.
But just that they change out those boxes, I think they could save you a few bucks. Those are some really nice boxes.
They're like, the boxes are perfect. They come with velvet wraps, and the inside of it is insulated better than pretty much anything NASA has ever produced. It's insane. Yeah. I could put that chocolate on the sun and eat it later because it's still in good condition. It's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, what's not to love?
Yeah, Alex, have I taken you there before? It's that one shop, so. Right? So, like,
you guys went on a date there,
maybe. But there's a little shop, right?
Run over my joke, maybe.
And when you look at the store, it doesn't look big at all. But then when you go inside, it's exactly. And it is the dessert there. I mean, is really good. I've been there a couple times. They usually do like a dessert of the month. I'm not sure if it's like a month or like a seasonal dessert. The dessert that we had was like an Aladdin type cake one time, which was really good. And I think one time they have, I ate there, and there was like a Mickey dessert type of thing. And I got like the domes over at Animal Kingdom. Yeah.
They have a bunch of different dessert, like even like, oh my gosh.
There's a whole bunch of pastry dessert, chocolate.
Yeah, I might have been there.
Yeah.
I think I got, oh my God, I'm forgetting the name of it.
Chip cookie.
No.
Rice cake.
No, they have feet.
Rice Krispie cake. Oh, feet. Birds.
Oh, sounds my God, like, I'm blanking. It's so annoying.
I think maybe one time I took you there and I was like, look at this place. This place looks so small on the outside, but when you go inside, it's really big. No?
Dude, you know what else is like that? Is if you go over to, when you walk into what used to be the entrance to Pleasure Island, and you walk up the steps and you got Enzo's on the left, and you go a little bit further and there's the Art of Shaving on the right.
Mm-hmm.
Right next to that is a place that, It's a honey place. Like, all they sell is honey.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the storefront is maybe, I don't know, 10 feet wide. But then you walk in and they have honey mead, honey beer, honey wine. It's like it's its own little mini bar and you'd never know. So Disney does a good job of hiding just how big those places are. It just looks like the world's fanciest outdoor strip mall.
That sounds but pretty cool.
You know?
Yeah, I need to go ahead and go there because I do like honey type of drinks and stuff like that.
So what's going on, man? When are we going back there? You guys going to Disney Springs anytime soon? I know you live a little bit out of the area.
I'm not sure. But I did hear that you are doing something new, Joey. Do you want to talk a little bit about that?
I appreciate that. Thank you, sir. So with the theme parks being closed, everybody who follows me anywhere on social media knows that I have a lot of gigs. You know, I'm a licensed minister in the state of Florida, so I can marry families, renew vows, things of that nature. The theme park gig is about 60 to 65% of my money. So because that's down, I had to find another full-time gig. I'm also a licensed realtor in the state of Florida. I'm a touring musician. The new gig, I was very fortunate. I work with Amanda Robinson Photography. Amanda is, she's one of the photographers for Chris Daughtry. She does photography for the Backstreet Boys. She basically, because of where we're out in the southeastern region of the United States, it's hard for a lot of famous New York, Los Angeles photographers to travel to Florida to photograph these famous bands because it's a very long trip for them. So she tends to be one of the photographers that they call. She's also, I've been very, very blessed, fortunate. She's my photographer. She took all of my album photos. Anytime I do a business card, anything, she hit me up and she's been so busy. She has me doing all of her digital media editing now. So if anybody out there needs anything from a Facebook profile to a business card to a headshot to a music video, hit me up on all social media platforms at the Joey Mazzant, the Joey, and of course Mazzant, Mazzant, and we can work with you. We can do anything you need that involves digital media processing, and I'd be more than happy to help. And of course, if you tell me you heard about this through Diz Hiz, we offer a significant discount and a solid hookup for you.
Nice.
Awesome.
You do digital editing?
I do. Something as kind and beautiful as if you have a family photo with deceased relatives and you want us to put everybody in it together, we can make that happen. Cool. If you want to go as big as if you are a musician who needs to have a music video done, we do all the video editing and the audio quality, and we will render everything for you, upload it to YouTube, and it's a big process. I didn't even know that this kind of media existed until I met her. So nothing but success and good stuff.
That's cool.
Awesome, Joey. Yeah, we have to kind of keep us updated on that and let us know how that's going for sure.
Well, thank you guys. I appreciate you letting me be a part of this amazing podcast. You guys are phenomenal. And I literally learned more from listening to you guys than I did from 4 years of high school and a horrible 2.5 years of college that literally earned me my most expensive coffee coaster.
Well, I think didn't learn much.
I think that can be like our motto, slogan. Our slogan. Yeah.
Joey learned more through his.
No, not Joey, but you can learn more through our podcast than 4 years of high school.
I agree with that. Yeah. My gosh, I'll sign my name to that comment.
Okay, Joey. Okay, Joey. Well, thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you guys. Have an amazing night and I'll see you next week.
See you. All right. Bye-bye.
Take care.
Okay, Adam, what did you do in the world or at the World of Disney, however you want me to say it?
Nothing.
Oh,
you can't make it a point to do one thing.
I know, man.
I was busy this week.
Okay, how about you, Alec?
I don't know what I was doing, but...
I did nothing. No, I watched the finale for Be Our Chef, which we liked that show.
Oh, okay.
It was pretty good.
And the winners get to go on a cruise or not?
They get to go on a cruise, yeah. And they win a week cruise as one of their rewards. Mm-hmm. And they get pins. Like, every time they win an event, they get pins. So they got a special pin for winning the whole thing. And it's funny because the team that won, it's like a family. It's two parents and two kids, right?
Yeah.
The team that won... had a daughter, one of their kids was a daughter and she was about 5, useless, not helping at all. She would walk around the studio. I mean, they've been doing this for a while, right? So the girl's getting used to it. The host will be holding her while she's talking to the camera because the girl's just like walking around just doing whatever. She'll walk over to other teams, start eating some of their food they have left over. And like, she's just walking everywhere. And it's really funny. So this team won and they were a man down pretty much.
Uh-huh.
And they still end up winning.
How old? So we had the adults, right? And then how old was the kid?
The youngest daughter was about 5 or 6. And, and then the second daughter, who was the one helping, who was really good, she was probably like 14 or 15.
Okay.
And she wants to go to culinary school.
Okay.
So she was really good. But it was not a bad show. I like those cooking shows, especially kid ones.
Yeah.
So it was pretty good.
Cool. Anything else?
No, I think that's it, actually.
Okay. Well, I watched The Little Mermaid and I watched Princess and the Frog.
Is that your first time seeing it?
It was my second time watching Princess and the Frog.
Okay.
And it's definitely a good movie.
I mean,
I like it better than Little Mermaid.
I do too.
Yeah. I like Louis, the alligator.
Mm-hmm. Louis.
Louis. He just wants to go and play his trumpet.
Big Lou.
Yeah, he wants to play his trumpet, man. He just wants to be with the human.
He's like, I jumped on a boat once.
Yeah, and they all shot at him or whatever.
Was it a flash? It was a flashback, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. But all he wants to do, man, is just play his trumpet.
Yeah.
So, and he finally got his chance at the end, which was really, it was cool to see. I think he's my favorite character in the whole story.
He's a good character.
I like the Ray.
Ray's a good character.
They have really good characters.
They do have good characters.
Yeah.
Disney makes good characters? No.
It's crazy.
Did you hear about, this is probably going to go to a little bit of the news part, but did you hear that there's like a petition to change Splash Mountain?
Yeah. Just tell me about this today.
I heard about that a while back.
So what section are they wanting to change? I know it's
the whole thing.
Part of the whole thing.
They want the whole theme to be changed.
And someone actually did a really good job of doing like concept art on how to change it.
So they want to get rid of Brer Rabbit.
Yes.
The whole thing. Yeah, and then they want to go ahead and...
I heard they want to change it to... I heard Christina said she read somewhere, and she thinks it's a great idea as well, is changing it to a Princess and the Frog theme.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, they're going to change it to Princess and the Frog. And someone...
They're not going to.
They might.
I mean...
I don't know that for sure, but...
Like, that's a overhaul.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I mean...
But just because it was in the movie... Like, I don't know.
That's what my brother-in-law was saying. He was like, because it was in the movie, like, for real, has nothing to do with it, but whatever. But I mean, I would be down for it. I love Princess of Frog.
I know, that's what I'm saying. I think, but this is not the only...
Wait, be down for it? That means that ride's going to be down for like a good year.
I feel like it's always down anyways.
Well, actually, so I was watching DFB, and I heard that...
The what now?
DFB, Disney Food Blog.
Okay.
I was watching their videos on YouTube, well, her videos, and they shut it down during the wintertime because it's a water ride, and then, you know, whenever it gets colder, they turn some of the water features off, like that splashy more.
Uh-huh.
So that's pretty cool. But, yeah, it is down quite a bit, but, I mean, you know, that's going to be a long... If they're changing the entire theming... I mean, you're taking out the briar patch, yeah, of what you're falling into.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, it's going to be, it'll be a lot of work. Yeah,
I guess so.
But I mean, I think even, let's just say they don't do Splash Mountain. I think Princess and the Frog deserves its own attraction.
But the thing is it was such a bust when it came out in the movies. It did terrible in theaters.
It did?
Yeah.
We should probably do some history on that one.
It's more of a cult classic. Uh-huh.
There's a lot of things we need to do history on. We need to do history on the what was in before. Oh, memories. I got another memory.
Oh, gosh.
So this has... Well, it's not this... Do you want me to tell you a memory of what was there before?
Yeah,
Frozen?
Go ahead.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Idol?
No, before that. The Superstar.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We're going to do... Wait. Yeah, we talked about it on history. You should have brought it up then.
Yeah, I know. I just
that's fine. It. You bring it up.
See, this is why we need that whiteboard so we can get to points. Yeah. I remember going there and you mentioned I Love Lucy. There's other shows. I saw Gilligan's Island and they called audience members up to be in the boat.
Uh-huh.
And they had people like on the sides with pails of water throwing it on them.
Oh, my
really?
Gosh.
Yeah.
That's pretty awesome.
That's awesome.
Yeah, and they were doing the whole scene. The boat was rocking and wow. They're showing how, you know, like the filming, how it would go.
Mm-hmm.
I remember American Idol there.
They even had someone like off to the side with the saw making the, you know, the thunder noises.
Oh, okay.
That was really cool.
That is
really cool. I remember American Idol there.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I went and saw that once.
That sounded like it would have been a terrible idea having just guests come up and sing.
They had it was before like when the park opened, you'd come and audition. You'd meet up at the
front
gate.
So you had to audition to make the shows, which would move on. But that's a lot of guests. They had to have like what, four people per show? And then they have like four or five shows a day?
Yeah.
A lot of people.
I'm sure people will go just to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, probably.
Sure, get noticed if they're really, really good.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. So I think, a cult classic would be Princess and the Frog. I think
to go on to your point about that, though, I think they'd have to come out with another movie to revive it.
Okay.
Live action.
That'd be kind of interesting.
Because why is anyone going to be interested in them building a ride for something that came out that long ago?
Well, they have on one of the cruise ships, they have the whole Princess Tiana's like restaurant.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that was put on
and
the cruise ship.
And that's really popular.
Right.
But they just did a roller coaster for Snow White. When did that movie come out?
That's true. That's true, too.
Okay, whatever.
Point bam.
Let's see what else here we got in news. I've been doing some this kind of like news / you know something that I did in Disney this week is Disney trivia. So you know we're on Sorcerer's Radio now, and so we've been doing some trivia on Tuesday nights at 7 p.m. So all you need is Zoom, and you need two devices: one to kind of see the questions, and then a second device to kind of answer the questions.
To log into Kahoot.com? Mm-hmm.
Kahoot, it's actually Kahoot.it.
Oh,
.it. And you type in like a pin.
Is it from Italy? countries. In other countries, the last...
Oh, maybe. I don't think so, though.
Yeah,
I'm not sure
if it's a Hong Kong, it would be .hk.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Maybe. I don't know. But it's really fun. This past weekend, we did Epcot trivia. This past week, we did Epcot trivia. This week coming up.
Oh, I missed that one.
Yeah.
Dang it.
we are going to do Pixar movie trivia.
Ooh.
So it's on Tuesday. If you want to check out our Twitter, we have all social media
accounts. Well, you're saying, I'm going to cut you off because you're messing this one up.
How?
Because it's today.
Oh, it is today.
Yeah, so tonight. If you're listening to this Eastern time,
yes,
then you need to join in by what time?
7 p.m. Eastern time. Yep, it's going to be today. I'm going to post the link on our Twitter because Instagram, we really can't do links on Instagram. Yeah. So on our Facebook and Twitter, I'll go ahead and post the Zoom link. And you can go ahead and join our Zoom room. And we're going to do some live trivia. It's a lot of fun. So just take a look at DizHiz65 on Twitter, Facebook, and I'll send the link out. But we did Epcot this past week, and it was a lot of fun. Let's see what else I got here for news.
I have something for news.
Oh, yeah? What do you got?
Yes. Do you know what comes out last week?
What's that?
But for our Patreon members, tomorrow.
What's that?
What is happening?
What?
What are you saying?
I don't know. I'm confused. Because, like Back to the Future. Or something exactly,
yeah. This show is coming out on Tuesday.
Correct.
But on June the 12th, which is tomorrow.
Okay.
Yeah. June 12th.
Yes.
Artemis Fowl comes out to Disney Plus.
Oh, cool.
And according to the Daily Beast, Disney's Artemis Fowl is an ugly flop that will infuriate the book fans. So
what is Artemis Fowl? What is this?
Enjoy. It's a movie that Disney made.
Yeah.
It came out a while ago it's coming out right now?
Coming out tomorrow.
And it's going to be terrible?
If you're listening to the podcast, yes.
Yeah, I guess like the critics reviews are already in.
Oh, okay.
Well, I guess we'll see because, you know, this is way off, not Disney, but Space Force got bad reviews, but I actually think it's pretty good.
Space Force.
Yeah, it was kind of good.
It's
slow.
Yeah, but yeah. People, they ripped it apart, but you can't really always believe what the critics say. So, I mean.
Well, Associated Press put Artemis Fowl wasn't worth the wait.
Okay. You can be a new
like
movie
the wait,
critic.
Like the wait in line at a theater?
Yeah, no. The Chicago Tribune, regrettably, Fairy Tale tries to catch in with Harry Potter crowd.
I think Adam should find his favorite dislike tweets or something for movies and just read them.
Thumbs up.
Two thumbs down.
So also some big news coming from Animal Kingdom Lodge is that, it's actually Animal Kingdom. So Animal Kingdom reportedly contracted for an external accommodation development by Animal Kingdom.
What does that mean?
Yeah.
Who knows? It can mean so many different things.
You didn't look into it.
No, I didn't look into it, but hold on. No. I did look into it, but they're not going to tell you what it is. I mean, they're buying land everywhere. They're not going to tell you exactly what's going to be there.
That means they bought land.
Yeah, they bought some
more.
I
just want to know what those words mean.
Right. He made it seem like he had this big news. I don't know what it means.
Well, it's cool that they're adding something new, right?
Yeah.
In Animal Kingdom.
But they're always adding something new.
Yeah.
Buying up land, protect it.
Yeah, sure.
Put some more solar panels that look like Mickey Mouse on it.
That's the Hiz on the first time in forever, a Frozen sing-along celebration at Hollywood Studios. I'm Joe.
I'm Alex.
I'm Adam.
Thanks for listening and have a magical week.
Go to DizHiz.com where you can find links to all of our episodes, our social media accounts, and to our Patreon page, where you can help us out and hear more from each of the shows. We also do monthly giveaways for our Patreon subscribers. Thanks for listening and have a magical week.